Welcome to the T-minus 60 multi-part video series on the topic of radiation effects. In this video, we will be discussing how space is a very different and much harsher environment than the terrestrial environment we live in. There are two sources of radiation, natural and man-made. The natural sources are a combination of cosmic radiation from outside the solar system, solar radiation from our sun, and particles that are trapped in the radiation belts that surround the Earth, which are called the Van Allen belts. The particles of interest from the natural environment are electrons, protons, and heavy ions. An example of a man-made source is a nuclear detonation, and the particles of interest are neutrons and photons. This video will focus on the natural radiation sources. Radiation belts can form around any planetary body that has a magnetic field. In fact, many planets in our solar system have radiation belts. Some are weak and some are very strong. The Earth's radiation fields are called the Van Allen belts, and they trap passing protons and electrons and are centered at the equator of the Earth, where our magnetic field is the strongest. The inner belts contain higher concentrations of protons and heavy ions, and the outer belt consists mainly of electrons, and that belt can fluctuate dramatically in response to the solar activity. Now let's look at the different types of orbits. The amount of exposure a satellite will see is very dependent upon its specific orbit, as well as the amount of solar activity during the time the vehicle is in space, aka the length of the mission. The most common terms used to discuss orbits is the distance from the Earth, and the examples are LEO, low Earth orbit, or MEO, medium Earth orbit, and lastly GEO, either geosynchronous or geostationary orbits. But also the inclination and shape of the vehicle's orbit have significant impact on the amount of radiation a satellite is exposed to and how they are positioned relative to the Van Allen belts. This chart summarizes the different types of orbits, LEO, MEO, and GEO, and how different orbits can potentially have significant overlap with either the inner or outer Van Allen belts. The chart also touches on the concepts of orbital period, which is represented on the vertical axis pointing up, as well as orbital speed, which is represented on the vertical axis, but this time pointed down. Lastly, it provides some context to the different orbits of some of the most well-known satellite constellations. For the LEO orbit examples, we have the International Space Station and the Hubble Telescope. For the MEO orbits, they are commonly for position, navigation, and timing type satellites, sometimes referred to as GPS constellations. And the last type is the GEO orbits on the outer ring of the diagram, which are commonly communication-centric. And then beyond that is the graveyard or disposal orbit, as it requires a significant amount of fuel to deorbit a GEO satellite back into the Earth's atmosphere. There has been a lot of technical material and radiation developed over the years, and we have tried to consolidate a good portion of it in our Radiation Handbook for Electronics. The handbook goes much deeper into this topic, as it is over 100 pages, as well as having hundreds of additional references you might find useful. Thank you for listening to this video on radiation types and orbit profiles. Please watch the next video to learn about time-dependent dose radiation effects.